No, they no can. Anyone is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is an evil liar. And we have no respect for him. If he's been deceived, we give him da'wah. If we clarify to him and he still is the Prophet Muhammad, like Bob the Lion, that they are liars, devils. Prophet Muhammad Sandu better than them million times. Just his Sandu. So that's for the record. And anyone try to lie against me, misquoting me, they'll know you're a kadab and I will not forgive you in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's how I believe, alhamdulillah. Not like Jonathan Brown, Muhammad Hijab, who his friend, he said, I believe in the freedom of insulting Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I don't believe in that. You cannot insult Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you cannot insult Jesus and the Prophet and messengers and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot insult them. Red line, these ones. You see, but anyway, to show you they're liars, these people. The point here is that look, they insult our Prophet, but we cannot insult their Prophet. Jesus, because if a Muslim insults Jesus, what is it? He will leave Islam. He's a kafir, murtad, and in Allah, apostate according to Islam. Salam alaikum, amimi. Hayakallah, gaybak. It comes out for subhanAllah. Look to the teaching of Islam. Look to the justice of Islam. That's why Ibn al-Qayyim, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, he said, subhanAllah. Prophet Ada Ibn al-Qayyim, one of the scholars, yeah? In his kitab, I believe it was in, what is it? Hidayat al-Hayara fi Ajwibat al-Yahudi wa al-Nasara. He wrote a book. He said Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi was defending Jesus. Either him, one of the ulama mentioned it. He was defending Prophet Muhammad sallam, in Medina. Prophet Muhammad sallam, was defending Jesus in Medina. And if he was a false prophet, he should have done what? He should have agreed with the Jewish people, because the heads of the pagan Arab, they used to respect Jewish rabbis. So if he agrees with the Jewish people, he will followers, but why he didn't agree with them? He disagreed with them, and there was no need. You know, one guy, he said, no, Shams, his argument is not that strong. I said, why? He said, because when Prophet Muhammad was in Medina, some Muslims, they were in Habasha, in Abyssinia. I said, yeah, but even if they were Abyssinia, Prophet Muhammad was saying clearly Jesus is not God. He's not son of God. And anyone that believes Jesus is son of God is a kafir. So that got against the teaching of the Abyssinian. So if he agreed with them, yes, you have a point. So that is a valid point, strong point, alhamdulillah. You understand, akhi? But you know, Allah blind them. Because the hatred they have against Islam, Allah blind their hearts.
No, but the problem, when you say something about Quran, they are free, they say about Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are free to say everything. As soon as you say something, you contradict the Bible, no, you are
what
a
you
good
can
person.
Do, what you can do, akhi? Like Ibn Taymiyyah did in his kitab, Ibn Qayyim, said you're according Jesus that you believe. So when you say Jesus that you believe, you're not talking about the true Jesus. So say, for example, I said Jesus you believe doesn't make any sense. He was like the Shia, the Ali they believe, he was more coward than any coward. See why? His wife getting beat up, and Ali ibn Abi Talib, the strongest man, they made him coward. So the Ali ibn Abi Talib, the Shia believe, he's a coward person. But Ali ibn Abi Talib that we believe, strongest, akhi. Strong man.
That's why
you powerful man. Warrior.
That's why you use your biblical word.
Yeah.
I use all the time I use
yes.
Biblical word.
Barakallahu feek. Say, the Jesus that you believe, okay, that's why the Ibn Qayyim said the Jesus of the Christians doesn't make any sense. Likewise of the Jewish people. The Jesus that makes sense is the Jesus in Islam. You see, so anyway, I want to make a clarification to the nation about specific situation. Because it's an obligation from the Lord of the creation. All right? I become an Arab. You know, Arab. يحب ال كيف أقول لك الشعر. Anyway. بسم الله الرحمن. Cut it off and a new video. New video is needed. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله. والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. Three weeks ago. When I was speaking about the issue that happened in Saudi, Bilad al-Haramain, the Dawlat al-Saudiya, Hafidha Allah, who may Allah protect it and all the Muslim countries, I said that, and I advised the Muslim leader in Saudi to about the Halloween, okay?
Halloween,
yeah, about the Halloween. That, as we have stated, Halloween is haram, no doubt about that. In Saudi, other Saudis haram. But now advising the Muslim leader specifically that opposes Sunnah, because the Sunnah to advise him in private. So I oppose the Sunnah and I take it back and I make it over to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And and even the way I did it, I was just challenging the Khawarij, show them like, look, I do advise. But I don't have to please the Khawarij, the enemies of the Sunnah of Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام, to show them that I follow the truth. Rather, when you do open advice to the Muslim leaders, there is some restriction for it. You can do it, by the way. Where, in the same country, now I'm in London, he's in the, and you believe, and you are a person of status, and you're not saying it to cause rebellion and to cause troublesome or problems. You're saying it for, in order for people to understand what has happened, it's wrong. And if the Muslim leader hears about it, there will be no harm. He will listen to it. Because they ask the Sunnah to take him by hand. And it's not for anyone. But me in London, speaking about the Saudi leaders or Algerian leaders, say, you can advise in general. We advise, we hope the Muslim leaders establish Sharia and, you know, have good people around them and so on, alhamdulillah. So what I did oppose the Sunnah. You see, alhamdulillah, our Sheikh Fawzi Hafidhahu Ta'ala, he refutes and rebukes what happened Halloween. But a subject to mention, excuse me, you're always with this cartoon, I don't know what you're doing.
I'm saving the world.
I save yourself, brother, after, before you start saving
and
the world.
Allah wipe my feet, I am the Messiah.
You're distracted.
Messiah,
okay, let's go there, let's go
Allah
there. That's why I speak Skona no good sometimes. You can't come behind me now. imagine you jump over the fence. He's like, I will show you, I'll come. Anyway, you know what's happening in the world, in Qatar? There's a World Cup, yes? And I just want to, people, please understand me correctly, yeah? I love Qatar, I love the people of Qatar. We love goodness for the Muslim leaders in Qatar, other than Qatar. But what I've noticed, that how come no one from the Ikhwan al-Muslimun, scholars or mashayikh, they're not speaking about it. You know how much Qatar spent on the World Cup? Over 220 billion. 220 billion. Not thousand, normally billion. I don't know how, but no one's speaking about it. No one coming out from this so-called du'at. The Muslims are dying out of anger. And you're spending 220 billion on a football. Where are you? Why are you not talking? Imagine that was in Saudi. You see day and night videos, clips against Saudi because they spent £2,000 or 20 million. You know? And by the way, okay, they had the World Cup, they spend it, mashallah, they're doing something good, which is utilizing it to give da'wah. But I'm just showing the hypocrisy of the people who wait for Saudi to do any mistake and pick on it, and they glorify it crazy. But when you have in Qatar, like, you know, people, music is open, free mixing, and we don't hear Zaki Naik or other people coming out. Free mixing is haram. Why no one speaking about it? Why? Saudi, yes. But no one heard about Saudi last week. They built, they spent over $1 million to build a hospital in Jordan for the refugees, for the Palestinian refugees. No one hears about it. So now my brothers and sisters out there, these so-called people who love good for the Muslims, if they really love good for the Muslims, why are they not speaking against Qatar? Which I don't agree with that. If you want to advise the leader, but I'm just showing the hypocrisy. Yeah? Do you know why? Because they hate Saudi. It's not about enjoying good for the evil. It's that we hate Saudi because a country of Tawheed al-Sunnah. So wait for any mistakes and glorify it. So now everyone's focusing on, we're going to give da'wah. But the haram that is taking place there, men free mixing with women, dancing, women leaving the house, coming, mixing with the men, jumping and with their buddies and so on. No one speaks about it. Again, to show the hypocrisy of Al-Ikhwan Al-Muflisin. Because Qatar is known to host Ikhwan. And we ask her to guide their leaders, to enlighten them about the danger of Ikhwan. And other than them, may Allah bless you all. You see, Salafi, alhamdulillah, say, Qatar, may Allah bless Qatar, may Allah bless all the Muslim countries. And may Allah rectify their mistakes, and may Allah aid them. But I will not call, no way, to call to start speaking about their mistakes every day and night, and try to put hatred in people's hearts to destroy the country. No, Qatar is a beautiful country. Khalij, generally speaking, even other countries, is stable, alhamdulillah. The masajid, alhamdulillah. You know, the Europeans cannot take it to see how much civilized is Qatar. Yeah. The hotels there is unbelievable. How clean is the road, mashallah. You know, hospitality of the people, young, you know, given dates and so on. You see, but look, I mentioned good. But those hates of Saudi, they will never mention good of Saudi. Never. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide the Muslim leaders, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring people who advise them sincerely, who aid them to establish Sharia. وصلى الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم سليما كثيرا بارك الله فيكم.